Welcome you all to this video on isometric drawing of a simple block in AutoCAD software. Myself, Dr. R.K. Julius, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering of B.S. Abdurrahman Krasan Institute of Science and Technology. And this AutoCAD drawing was done by Mr. V.E. Vijay Kumar, technical staff in the CAD laboratory of our institution. Okay, let us first try to understand the model that we are going to create in this particular video. So as you could see in the screen, the three-dimensional view, okay, actually the isometric view of a particular block is given here. The same isometric drawing we are going to create in the AutoCAD software. So here we have circular features. So this is circular feature is one important thing that you have to do in isometric. It is not like usual, okay, that we will see in the software. Before that, try to understand the diagram. Actually, it is a simple diagram. As you could see there, in the front side, the arrow is representing the front side. In the front side, there is a slot kind of thing. Apart from that, there is no big changes. Okay, in the other side, I have a circular hole and a semicircular region. Okay, so it's a very simple thing. Try to remember the dimensions. The slot distance is 30 and 15 on both sides, and the depth for the slot is 10 units. The overall thickness of the object is 20 units. Okay, now from the front side to the center of the circle, there is a distance of 38, and then we have a circle hole. Okay, it's actually a hole for dia 30, and then that hemispherical region is of R30. Okay, so this is about the object. Okay, okay, as usual, go to file new, use the AutoCAD template and open a new window. So this time we are going for isometric. As first let us set the limits as for A4 page. Okay, so you use a limit max command and enter the value as 297, 210. Okay, now you can give zoom all to generate everything, and then we are going to isometric option. So go for span, snap. Okay, snap, and enter the option, okay, ISO, and enter the gap also. Okay, you can use I to mention ISO, and you can change the plane also. Okay, you can change the ISO plane. Now in this diagram we need to draw a circle. Okay, for that you cannot draw a circle directly, you have to go for ellipse. So please remember, you have to draw an ellipse. Okay, to represent a circle you have to draw an ellipse. So here we are creating an ellipse. And use quad command. Okay, we are going to in the midpoint. So for that we are using a quadrant command. Okay, we will use line. Okay, you will use line. You will take from the center of the line and connect it to the end. So okay, from the center of the line, you just draw a line along the angle. With the correct angle, extend it to some distance and trim the unwanted region, so that you will get the end point of that circle. Okay, we need the tangent for that. You can draw a line at the appropriate angle, and then you can get the point. Okay, so now from that point you start drawing from the circumference of the circle corresponding to that line. Okay, the end point of the line, you start the diagram and specify the value for the line. Okay, the angle, the distance, the necessary distance is 38 and angle 210. Okay, you should remember the different angles that we used in the previous exercise. So accordingly use the appropriate angle and the distance to draw the lines. Okay, so as per the diagram that we discussed, we have to draw the lines, and you just remember that you can even do extensions. Okay, instead of angle you can extend it along the direction of the isoplane, and then you can give the value also, right? Okay, So this line is coinciding along the circle. You need not bother about it. Okay, we are going to trim away that ridge, that portion of the circle. So as per the dimensions, you just draw the lines. So in that particular plane, we have the lines, the features coming like this. So you can complete it. I can zoom it. So we want to trim the unwanted portion, so you can even magnify if required. Now go for trim option and trim the unwanted region. Okay, so this is not the correct one. Probably we have to you can cancel and probably we will complete this line. Okay, complete as a we'll draw a complete line and then trim the unwanted portions. Please ensure that the angle for that line is appropriate. Okay, now you trim out the trim. You can even magnify or you can delete. Okay, so appropriately you can remove that particular region of the circle. So now you can delete the center lines also. Okay, along the lines passing along the center of the circle, there also you can delete. Now we have to draw another circle from the midpoint. We are drawing another circle, actually ellipse. Okay, here it is ellipse, not circle. To represent circle, you have to draw ellipse. So you go to ellipse, specify the radius and draw the ellipse in the isometric. In isometric, you have to draw ellipse instead of circle. Now the top line is over, we are moving towards the other the depth. Okay, we are going to represent the depth. So use the appropriate angle. So we are using copy. Okay, instead of drawing it again, we are using copy. In isometric, it is better to use copy whenever the same features are repeated, because it will be easy for you. So we copy wherever is possible. Okay, you use the copy command, copy the necessary lines, and with respect to the endpoint, you move it to the another endpoint. Okay, now we have done some of the features and trimming away the remaining things. Now for the sides also, you can copy. So finish that line, and now for the sides also you will copy the circle and the line. Okay, so now we have to draw that vertical line. So trim the unwanted portions. So from the line you have to draw appropriately. So we are doing quadrant. Okay, from the quadrant, first point in the bottom circle to the top circle, vertical line. Okay, so now we try to draw the aligned dimensions. Before that, let us define the dimension parameters. So you go for ddim. Okay, and change the text height, the arrow size. Okay, the decimal places, change the number of decimal places. So apply new set current and close it. So now we will create the dimensions. I'll use align dimensions, select lines and so use the same command. You can just enter. Okay, if you in AutoCAD, if you use the enter command, once you complete the one particular command and you want to go back to the command again, okay, if you just enter, the previous command will be activated. So create all the necessary dimensions. So for circle, arc and all, you cannot create the dimensions directly, okay. In AutoCAD it is not possible to create the dimension isometric, okay. In isometric you cannot create the angle, radius, dimensions directly. So instead of that we go for other options, okay. Leader, you use the leader line, or you just draw the dimension between the two lines, okay. You can in the center of the circle we have lines, so you can create dimensions for those lines from one point to another point like that. But for circle you cannot create directly, so you will go for leader line, okay. You can go to leader line and type the values like this. So create leader line from the nearest entity, nearest circle. Type the values. Okay, first position it appropriately and then give enter. Now give the annotation. So here you have to type, okay, in the align dimensions the dimension value will come automatically. Here you have to type, okay, you have to annotate. So now go for dimension edit, select the objects, okay, and we have to give the oblique angle. Use the same command to align all the dimensions. Change the angle for all the dimensions. Give appropriate angles. So please ensure that all the dimension lines, extension lines for dimension are aligned along the isometric lines, okay, they should be parallel to isometric lines. So now you can save the model, thank you for watching this video.